Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2443, a two-way lookup, three ways. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. A great question sent in today from Minnesota. They have two worksheets, and they'd like to do a VLOOKUP, but it's not just a regular VLOOKUP, because the sales tax file can have two rates for the same city. So down here on the tax worksheet, Abbeville has a 6.5 rate and a 9 rate. And this is the tax code for the first one, tax code for the second one. On the place where they're doing the VLOOKUP, Abbeville, I don't know how to pronounce that, we have a rate of 9, so what's the tax code? And so in that case, it'd be 35010. Now, three different ways that I can think of to solve this. The first and easiest way would be to use an XLOOKUP, but the problem is you may or may not have an XLOOKUP, right? So here's our tax worksheet that has city, rate, and then what the tax code is. And then back here we have city and rate. So XLOOKUP, we're gonna look up the concatenation of A2 ampersand B2. So we're looking up Centerville 0.015, comma. First thing we wanna do is, where's the lookup array? So I'm gonna, after typing the comma, I'm gonna press control page down. And we're gonna take everything in A2 to A144, that was control shift down arrow. I'll press the F4 key, ampersand, and then control shift down arrow from B2, again press the F4 key. So our lookup table is going to be everything in A concatenated with everything in B, and the beautiful thing about XLOOKUP is it can deal with that, comma. And then the results array is going to be over here in column C, so we'll start up in C2, control shift down arrow, press F4, again. XLOOKUP, we don't have to say that we're looking for an exact match, it's automatic, right? So we just have three arguments there, and press enter. Centerville 0.015 is 38219. Let's check that. So up here at the top, Centerville 0.015 is 38219. Beautiful, it looks like it's working. Double click to copy it down. All right, so that's actually my method two, using XLOOKUP. And while I was doing this, I realized, well, wait, the method three wouldn't be that much worse in case you don't have XLOOKUP. You certainly have VLOOKUP, everyone has VLOOKUP. And so to do this, I would come back here and I would either insert a new row between B and C or a row to the left. I don't know which one. I don't know. Let's just go here and I'll call it key, the key field. So equal afton A2 ampersand C2. So equal B2 ampersand C2. Double click and copy that down. Okay, so now I have a concatenated key and my VLOOKUP will be a little bit simpler. So the method here will be equal VLOOKUP of Centerville ampersand 0.015 comma, and then control page down to get to the next worksheet, and here it'll be all four columns. We'll press F4 and we want the fourth column, and we have to say that we want an exact match, so comma false, like that, 38219. Double click and copy that down. Right, so two different ways. The third way in theory is the easiest, but it's actually the most destructive. So we start out here with Centerville and rate and our data back here. And for each one, we either need to create a named range or convert it to a table. So control T for a table, and we'll call this the state sheet. So state, and then here, control T for table, and we'll call this the tax sheet. All right, now two steps that seem like they're pointless, but it really is important. Okay, so we are on our state table and we're gonna choose data from sheet. Now, if you don't have XLOOKUP, there's a good chance that it says from table or range. It's in the same general area in the get and transform data. So we choose from sheet. And the only thing I have to do here, I don't need the tax code, I'll remove that. And I need to add a index column. If you're a programmer, you're gonna choose from zero, but if you're an accountant, you're gonna choose from one. Everyone else, I don't know, whatever you wanna do, it doesn't matter either way. All right, that's good. Home, don't click close and load, click close and load two, and say only create a connection. All right, that's first extra step. Then on the tax sheet, this one will actually be easier, from sheet or from table or range, and then just directly close and load two, only create a connection. Then we'll come back here to our state sheet, just kind of off here to the right a little bit. Get data, combine queries, merge, And we're gonna merge those two connections we just created. So we'll start from the state sheet and link to the tax sheet. Now on the state sheet, we're gonna click on city first and then control click on rate. And you'll see the little one and two to show you what order you clicked on those. City and then rate one and the two. Everything from the first matching from the second, click okay. All right, and this step right here, we're still fine. Centerville, Grant, or St. Paul. The thing that really annoys me here is when I get the tax rate out, right? So I expand this, choose tax code. I don't need the original column name as a prefix. Centerville, Grant, St. Paul, click OK. I have no idea why it's reordered in this order. It's not alphabetical. It makes no sense to me at all. I'm starting from the left table. It should stay in the same order as the left table. That's why we had to add the index column back here. Just super insane that we had to do that. At this point, I'm really tempted to delete the index column, but I'm just gonna leave it there out of superstition. I guess I should test it both ways. Centerville, Grant, St. Paul. Let's try it without. We'll remove Centerville, Grant, St. Paul. Close and load two. This time we're gonna bring it to the grid, but to an existing worksheet right there in G1. Click okay. All right, and it looks like all of the stuff stayed in the same sequence. If you don't have that index column, you end up with data back here in the wrong sequence, and then there's no easy way to just take this control C and paste special values into the tax code. Now, if you really want to be careful, and I actually did this the first time, check and make sure that Centerville is equal to Centerville and that they're all identical all the way down, and they are. We can test that with a little true or equal and at the bottom, and that will be true. All right, there you go. I was really thrown for a loop the first time I recorded this when the data came back and it wasn't in the same sequence. I'm like, what? Why? And I've heard you can't trust Power Query to sort your data. I've heard that. Never been burned by it before. All right, so there you go. Three different ways. The XLOOKUP, I think if you have XLOOKUP, is probably the way to go. If you don't have XLOOKUP, then the concatenated key with the VLOOKUP, or if you need something that you can refresh, then the Power Query, the three queries in Power Query. You know, the thing I don't know here is I don't know what else is in the data. I have to believe that there were more columns here, right? And they sent me a simplified version. So it's probably more complicated than what they sent me. It always is. All right. Well, hey, this book, MrExcel 2021, Unmasking Excel, definitely a lot of VLOOKUP, 12 XLOOKUP examples in there, and Power Query as well. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hit it, Nancy.